And joining us now here on NHL Now is Gavin McHale. Gavin, thanks for taking some time to chat with us. The most interesting part of this story for me was that this wasn't your first time having this experience. Tell us about the first time this happened to you.
Last season, I guess in February, I was doing the job for the Jets, and Colorado was in town, and Jonathan Bernier took one off the head. And I knew something was up, but when Varlamov came out for the third period and there was no one in the tunnel, and then I got a tap on the shoulder from the Jets PR guy saying, you need to get your gear and get to the Avalanche room as fast as you can.
Now, we have the picture up there. We show you wearing the Avs jersey there, no old number 61 in the big moment there. But like, it's our understanding that they did not let you keep that jersey.
Unfortunately, they did not, and hopefully this will get me that jersey. I don't know.
I mean, that's not right. That is not right.
Gavin, you're a big guy. You're 6'7". Is that correct? It's kind of hard even. Do they have the jerseys that fit you over goalie gear? Because they don't carry jerseys. Is that like a 58, size 60? What is that jersey?
Well, I think those new NHL regulation jerseys, I don't know if they're like if they're actually goalie jerseys, but they're definitely pretty tight. And I think that's what set me back in warm up against the with the Caps there.
Gavin, one of the nuances of the Winnipeg Arena is that you don't get to sit on the bench. So even when you're on the team, you have to sit in the tunnel. Did you maybe ask for guys, scooch over a little bit, let me come hang on the bench for the games so you get a big part of the whole experience?
I just didn't want to cause any problems. They told me where to go, and I went there.
Squeaky wheel gets the grease, Gavin.
Yeah, probably a smart play by you. Now, from what I understand, this is a bit of a rotation situation in terms of emergency goaltenders, and you guys rotate through during the game. So this has happened to you twice now. Are you starting to feel super lucky or what?
I am. I'm actually working the game tonight as well, and you never know. It could be two in a row. I could be doing this whole thing all over again in a couple of days.
Talk to you Monday.
I've got a couple of guys meeting the bus out there for Buffalo, so you will be getting the call.
Just in case, yeah.
I wanted to ask you about, in the warm-up against the Caps. You know, it's one thing to go in different team situations, but Alex Ovechkin is out there. Did you face a couple of Ovi shots?
Actually, my first shot was off the stick of Ovechkin, and I wasn't even close. So it is what it is, right?
Oh, that's right.
You won in 600 under NHL goalies, Gavin. You're in good company in there. Now, be honest with me here. Honest. When you go into a game like that, are you hoping that they get blown out so you can get in there, or they get up big so you can get in there? Do you want something to happen so you can actually get in the game? Or are you kind of nervous, like, I'm here, I'm happy to watch closely, but man, I hope Phoenix Crosby finishes this game?
So for most of the game, that was the case. I was like, hey, it's a 1-1 game. Both boys are playing well. Let's, let's just keep this going. When that empty netter went in with about a minute left, I can tell you, I was hoping for the call. I was
yes.
like, hey, this is my chance. There's no pressure at all. I just want to get the call. But you know what? It was, I was pretty comfortable in that seat watching the game.
I'm putting a call into Todd Reirden, my former teammate. Hey, Todd, figure it out. Get him in there next time.
Oh, yeah. Should have done it for you.
Yeah, you could have skated really quick to the bench for a change last minute to get the goalie out again. It would have been great. Yeah.
I appreciate the honesty, too, an honest answer from you. So this is obviously one title, emergency backup goaltender. Tell us about what you do in your day-to-day life. What's your occupation?
I'm a strength and conditioning coach. So I work with clients in the gym, and then I work with a lot of former hockey players online. And I'm also a goalie coach with University of Manitoba and a local junior team here in Winnipeg.
All right, Gavin, so it was a brilliant night. You got to hang out with the Stanley Cup champs. You got to take shots and warm up from Ovi. At the end of the day, last time this happened, you didn't get the jersey. What did you come out of this game with? The jersey, signed sticks? What did you leave beyond just the memories?
I got a pretty good swag bag.
Nice.
They gave me the jersey, which was awesome. They gave me the undershirt. They gave me an undershirt to wear under my gear. The hat that I wore. They even had a stall tag made up for me, which was ridiculous. I don't know how those equipment guys do it.
Did they have your name on the jersey? Was your name on the jersey?
Yeah. You can kind of see it's a bit of a shoddy sewing job. It was pretty quick. It was pretty impressive that they did that. And before I even got the chance to ask Obi for an autograph, he showed up with a signed stick as a thank you. and Holtby walked in right after him with a signed stick, and we chatted for a few minutes. So it was I got a pretty good haul out of it.
Nice.
What did Braden say to you when he approached you at your new stall?
Well, actually, I played in his hometown for almost a season in Lloydminster, Alberta. So we knew some mutual friends, and we kind of chatted about the good old days in Lloydminster mostly. So not too much time. I knew that this was my last chance to take his stall. So,
well, Gavin, based on the details of this swag bag, it sounds like Colorado has been one-upped, maybe like three-upped based on what you're walking away with. Who knows? You sound like a lucky guy. You've done this twice already, so this might not be the last time that we talk to you. Enjoy the game tonight.